With me now is Jeff Maskell. He's the chairman of the Devizes and District War Games Group. Now, could you explain what exactly that involves?
Well, basically, it consists of playing toy soldiers.
Yeah.
Depending upon the size of the toy soldiers, like-minded people gather together with their own little army of painted tin and meet in mortal combat across the field.
What is the attraction, do you think, of such grown adults, and if I can insult you here, is sort of just sort of playing around with little toys?
You can insult me any way you like, but the attraction is the recreation of periods past, of things we could never do, which is run around in the middle of a battalion of infantry or what have you.
Is it just a setup of different groups of soldiers fighting against each other, or is it actual battles that took place that you try to recreate?
Either or, depending upon how the mood grabs one. We can either have we've refought Waterloo and so on and so forth.
And you try to do that with the same amount of troops that
were there? Absolutely so. Oh yes, everything in its place, everything in detail and as it was then.
The actual figures, I presume you wouldn't make them yourselves, but the
these are commercially available.
Yeah. And they're sort of no colours, you just sort of paint them whatever uniform you like.
They start off as this little fellow here, a mixture of lead and tin, basically a little solder chappy. And we add the details, painting them and so on, and organise them.
That's about half an inch high. How much are they?
They're about 8 or 9p for half an inch. The big ones here, the chappies on the camels, they go for about 50, 60 pence unpainted. And it's not unusual for a painted army to sell for £120, £150 or thereabouts.
How many members are there in the War Games group?
We've got about 30 in Devizes.
Is it based anywhere else? Have you fellow members across the country? I mean, is
that... Well, we draw from the whole of Wiltshire. The nearest ones to us are Oxford and Newbury and Bristol, Bath.
And do you come together and sort of have battles together?
Every Sunday afternoon.
Really?
Absolutely, yes.
What about noise effects? Do you all sit around saying bang, bang and things? Or...
Well, for people that do that tend to be frowned upon. It has been known to happen, though. It has been known to happen.
So you're going
to
hit me in a minute, for instance?
Not at all. Not at all.
So what majority of the time is spent recreating the actual... I mean, are you... how can I put it? You spend a lot of time setting up the battles for all the detail, or is it just roughly a few troops here and a few troops there?
There's a lot of research if you're going to do a historically accurate battle. Yeah. A lot of research goes into it. For the general run-of-the-mill Sunday afternoon enjoy-yourself battle, it's just a matter of deciding what you're going to have, and lining them up and getting stuck in. It's rather like playing chess. In fact, it's very similar to playing chess. The only difference is that in chess you know what your pieces are going to do and what they're capable of.
Yeah.
In a war game you don't know. They can turn and run or exceed all expectations or what have you.
Now you say you want to recreate battles as part of the reason why you're behind it. Why not just sort of dress up in the uniforms and go into a field? That'd be more realistic, wouldn't it?
Well, it's strange you should say that, because to your right over there we have a chappy already in uniform. He belongs to a society which recreates battles of yesteryear. He's the French infantry of the 21st Line Regiment. He's the exception to our club rather than the rule. There are several societies in the country dressing up and bashing each other, ranging from the Romans in Gloucestershire way up to modern chaps down in Cornwall with all the vehicles and the full equipment.
What are you doing now?
We're just painting up some stuff for the display in front of us. So the public can get an idea of what they look like and how they look.
Yeah.
Hopefully find some more members.
Now to our left we've got an actual scenery here.
This is depicting
a particular battle.
This is just an ad hoc game, basically for the younger element to keep them busy.
Yeah.
It's computer moderated. The computer works out the odds and decides if anything's hit or what have you. It seems to be keeping them well entertained.
You say for the younger elements, what sort of age group are there? Is it all ages or mainly elder?
All the way through. Our eldest member is about 80 and our youngest is about 11 or 12. So it appeals to people of all ages really.
And you go around presumably to these sort of dues and just display your wares?
We go all over the country playing soldiers, basically playing soldiers. There's many, many conventions all up and down the country. We started about 15 years ago with about three of us in a very cold and drafty garret, traditional way of starting anything really.
Yeah.
And we're now 30 strong, going from strength to strength. We must have got through about 50 or 60 members in that time, I suppose. Some have gone to New Zealand and taken the word out there all over the place. We're certainly one of the original clubs in the country.